both sides looking for a win.
Get!
Full toss straight away. Yeah! Does it carry? What a start, Robert Croft.
Oh, what a start it was.
For Sussex, as we can see this delivery.
Yeah!
Knee-high full toss. Could have hit it anywhere. And a beautiful diving catch. Moving forward there by the captain, Ravi Bopara.
Oh, lovely.
Not a bad way to start, but a bad delivery. They're short and cut away.
But Ward's probably got a little bit nervy. He's bowled two full toss. He's overcompensated. That's a long hop, gets cut away. Pick the gap, good strike.
Another left armer. Oh, Ray left armer, going to see. Does he get a wicket with his first ball? He does. Given out. Not happy, James Bracey.
In halfway down into the pitch, ready for the cut. But the appeal goes up.
For Stephen Flint. Punished, but not punished well enough. Cut hard by Cobain. And a simple catch. And Sussex have three wickets.
Yeah, it's the second wicket they've had from the short, wide delivery. A delivery like that, you've got to put it away. And Cobain just hits it straight to Delroy Rawlins into his midriff, and he takes a comfortable catch.
All punished. A little bit overpitched, a little bit floaty. And it was a nice way to finish off the over. Five overs gone. 21 for three.
Oh, nice, good timing from Glenn Phillips. Such a powerful striker of the ball. Slightly overpitched from Tamal Mill.
Great shot. I think Sussex, as much as they'll be happy with those three wickets, they know what a danger this man is. He got a 97, I think it was, last year against us here, and smashes absolutely everywhere. So.
Oh, that's a good pick-up. It's aerial. It's an excellent effort, actually. I think that's Ollie Carter out there on the boundary.
I think he might have just got a fingertip on this, actually, after that. It's a decent shot. Yeah, maybe just a fingertip. Great effort. Shame. It'd be nice if that one stuck. But...
Oh, brilliant area to try and target straight down the ground. Manages to beat long on and long off. Bowed both out there trying to run round to cut it up.
And this is why he's so dangerous, just that power, belly.
Catch it!
Leaving the leg side open, should be taken, and is. That's a comfortable catch out in the deep, and Sussex get their four.
Lovely bit of bowling, just held it back a little bit, and just at the bottom of the bat, it's just not quite got hold of it, and a good running in catch again from Tom Allsop.
Which I can achieve within it.
That's managed to squeeze through. Has got enough pace to reach the boundary. A welcome one from Gloucestershire's perspective. Phillips needs to start finding his rhythm and finding it fast. Same sort of region from Phillips. And exactly the same result. That's very well played, really nicely done, just using the pace, releasing the hands ever so fractionally, and it's the end of the 12th. Oh. Almost. Fortunate. All Finn can do is howl in anguish as the ball careers into the boundary. There we go. There we go. He might have just turned his bat on. Just flicked the switch. That was in his arc, and it seared over the boundary rope.
Best part of just under six overs to go. To have any chance of getting a win, they've got to get a good total.
Yeah, absolutely. And something you said before, he's been in for that period of time, and he's gauged.
Yeah.
Taking pace off it there, out of the back of the hand. It doesn't matter. Accelerated off the bat through quick hand speed from Glenn Phillips. That change up, long chase in vain, and again gone to the back of the hand, slower ball, wasn't hit cleanly but well enough to reach the boundary and bring Grant Phillips.
Knots. Well, does he get this in the gap? I think he does, yeah, just in a way, pace on and punish through the leg side. So a boundary to finish the over, 101 for four, cement their place in the top four. High. Taylor gets a little bit of a top edge, it will be safe and will run away just for a boundary. Well, that's well bowled. it's just a perfect yorker that gets an outside edge. Powerful, so powerful, Glenn Phillips, and this will go all the way. Well, with this last shot, I'm sure that Gloucester want this man on strike as much as possible. It is a length delivery. It is right in that slot. Yeah, that's a good shot. That's a good shot, that went for the yorker. His partnership has been excellent, 77 from 50 deliveries.
Yeah, it was these two that did it last year.
Cut, and cut hard. Robin Smith's style, it's a boundary. Big shot, into the surface, slower delivery, probably a poor delivery from Finn.
It was just dragged back, that just allowed Taylor stand still, hand through the ball. The shorter side of the ground here as well at Hove. Nicely timed.
Last ball then for Finn. Powered over extra cover. It's a good end to the over for Gloucester and Jack Taylor. 16 runs from the over, 142 for four. All bowled. May have got away with a length ball, but you don't care at the end.
A huge amount of momentum. He's just dragged on, looking to go down the ground, trying to drag it over onto the leg side.
Oh, he tried to go for the boundary, go for a single. Brilliant from the keeper, I'm sure. We'll have to have a look at it.
Anyhow, having a big swipe, first delivery. Pretty sure he's going to be on his way back to the pavilion. Bales are off there and is short of his ground by a good couple of inches.
Oh, another excellent delivery. Another chance of a run out. Maybe overthrows, everything's happening. A little bit slower. It'd just be a single, has to be a single. So that is the end of the Gloucester innings. Oh, big shout, has to be out, is out. It's a perfect delivery. Absolute beauty from Payne. Length, line and swing.
Perfect start. That's exactly what he's been picked in the England squad to do. If there's swing out there, he gets it. That's a perfect bit of left arm bowling. Pitch it up, swing.
Oh,
down.
Yes, sorry. Oh, misfield. Misfield. Josh Shaw should have stopped it. It runs away for a boundary. It's a horrible game, isn't it?
Well, that's one thing Gloucestershire can't afford to do, is be poor in the field. Oh, it's like the guy with the glasses in the trying to take the catch earlier.
Oh, it's a good shot. It's a good shot. Decided that, all right, he's missed one. He's got a lucky boundary and an inside edge, but this is a clever shot.
And obviously, from Allsop's point of view, drops down the wicket, that's a great shot. Hits through the line of the ball. But as I said, he's been really positive.
David Payne again. Slip out this time. It's beautiful timing. There's one thing, if you've ever watched Ravi Bopara in his career, hands and timing. Excellent.
Passes it, just passed behind, back of the point. All timing. Absolutely great shot.
Yeah, that was a lovely angle that you could just see his eye. Still swings it. Oh, does he get a little bit of outside edge? He does. A little bit of swing there.
Obviously, Tom Allsop's come out and he's tried to be really positive, but from a bowler's point of view, don't lose, as you said. You've got to take wickets, keep your slipping.
Now the wicket in the air. Does he get enough of it? I think he does. It's in front of square. Couple of bounces, boundary. Too short, really.
And he's just showing that when you're feeling confident, you really take it to that bowler. You know, if you can have a good power play here.
Oh, inside edge. And when you get a bit of luck, why not? Keep it going.
But that's the nature of T20 cricket. When you're playing well, little things like that seem to go for you, and you forget that as a batter when you go in bad form. But unlucky for the bowler, but it's four runs in the book. Tom won't care too much.
Oh, pulled away. This is good shot. Shaw followed him.
Looking to sit back, anything short of a length he's really getting onto. But I think the one thing Sussex did well was actually more of a 4-day length in that first part in the power play. Just got the batters coming forward. I think if anything here, obviously from Shaw, just bowling a bit too short.
Oh, top edge, top edge. Does it go to the fielder? Yes. Big wicket for Gloucester. Ravibhuparu tried to work it to the leg side. And the away side needed that wicket.
You know, when pace, when the wicket is slightly too paced and you go across the ball, it's always difficult, but just gets a thick outside edge.
This is really, really nicely timed from Allsop. We have seen he has risen his luck, but...
It's a bit of drift in towards middle of the leg and he just steps on top of the bounce.
Oh, you're joking.
Another one. You can hear the frustration from James Bracey behind the stumps.
Pressure was building down the wicket, turns a little bit. He just gets enough of the top edge on this delivery.
Oh, he's got that. That has gone very fine. Tom Allsop. So that will bring up his 50 as well.
Earlier on in the over, there was a bit of luck. Four runs.
Sliced away. It's going to be four. The width offered. And it just scorches the outfield on the way to the boundary.
Just a nice, easy shot. Yeah, too much width there. Just get any bat on it. And off it races for
pounds for 100. Pulled out into the deep, but into space, and enough. Four more, onto the Allsop total. He's getting these on his own. Oh, he's got all of that, all of it. Right in full, in front of that pack stand, right from the moment he connected.
Time spinner's now come on, and he thought, like, this is the over, attack down there.
Now, this may have the distance. Oh, it's quality. You see it so often. They practice it. No matter how many times you see it, that teamwork. I think he's going to be safe.
Yeah, I think it just looks like he's touching it, doesn't he?
Is it a shin or is it just a little bit of toe? I think, actually. Oh, have some more. That's just sat up. And I don't think he's got all of that, to be perfectly honest, Tom Allsop.
Yeah, great shot again. Just looking to use that power into that short side. Wants to get this game over and done with. To build the partnerships up. Now really try and get this game done. Great shot again by Tom. Batting absolutely beautifully here.
Yay!
Oh, nice piece of work from Bracey. Just leaning out of the crease. The weight wasn't totally balanced from Finn Hudson-Prentice.
The batter's feet late and he's just thrown it down that leg side, just seen him come. Lovely bit of keeping. Yeah, nice bit of work there.
Yeah! Now he wants another one. Little bit more optimistic, although he seems convinced, all keepers usually do.
Here we go.
No problems there. Foot just up, yeah, good work again. Edged, gone, yeah, heard a little nick, as did Richard Kettlebrook. Good pace and bounce from Zach Chappell.
You're probably thinking the ball was going to be pitched up. Surprise bouncer, as you said. Good pace, tiny little nick on it from the batter's point of view.
Yeah!
Oh, hang on, there might be a little twist. Another wicket, Phillips has his first. It's beautiful hands from Bracey.
Third against the spin. Not a huge amount of turn, but yeah, I think that's taken a deflection into James Bracey's glove.
Tack!
In the air. In the air, should be out. Is out. Are we seeing a twist here at Hove? Caught by Phillips. And it's that man again, Benny Howell.
Backwards really to try and track it. It was in the air a long time. He also had Zach Chappell coming in into his eye line from the deep cover boundary there.
Oh, in the air, in the air. Who wants it? The keeper? No, the bowler. Caught and bowled. It's a big wicket.
Well, Gloucestershire will feel that they can win this now with the way that they've pulled it back, the wickets that they've taken. the way they've taken the wickets. They've made Sussex do things.
Bolt, full and straight. It's brilliant from Zach Chappell and from Gloucester.
Just clawed their way back into the game. Excellent from Chappell, full and straight.
What does he do, 17-year-old? Cut away, take the one, take the one. In the air, Bracey is under it. Is this the match for Gloucester? It is. What a comeback. What a comeback for Gloucestershire. How have they pulled this game off?